house. As Vinisa mentioned, my name is Hussein Kasai. I'm one of the co-founders of Onfido Background Checks, and I want to start with a few questions. Would you allow a stranger into your house to tutor a child of yours? Would you allow a stranger into your house to clean it for you? Or would you allow a stranger to come and stay overnight in one of your spare bedrooms or spare car seats or any other thing that you may have? Now, traditionally, the answer would have been probably not. And increasingly, we're finding that more and more individuals are choosing to do so. And they're doing so because of this wonderful new business model called the sharing economy and on-demand services. And from the early days, sort of trust has been pivotal and core to making the whole sector work. And the reason for that is because increasingly, as individuals interact with each other, they don't have the time to develop that trust, and they want it instantly, and they want it to be able to know that there are these platforms that are doing a thorough job. And that's where we come in. We at Onfido Background Checks help our sort of customers in the different platforms. We help them build trust into the sharing economy by carrying out automated identity, criminal, rights to work, and other checks. And what we're finding is that increasingly, as well as our focus of being growth, that a lot of the platforms are focusing more and more on trust. And we've all heard of the stories of Uber and others, and it's increasingly going to be an area of focus. And the technologies that are enabling the market to grow include background checks, which is what we essentially specialize in. There are limitations to what we're able to do, and we are looking for a bit of help, especially from the government, in order to be able to offer more services and be able to further help the sector grow. So the three core ones, one is speed. Now, in an on-demand workforce where you are looking for services as soon as possible, it's important for us to be able to carry out background checks as fast and as quickly as possible. Now, there are limitations in terms of what we can deliver, partly on criminal record checks. And criminal record checks can take 2, 3, sometimes up to 6 weeks. So by digitalizing these checks, then we are in turn able to offer them at a faster rate, which is exactly what the sector needs more than anything. Secondly is cost. So again, some of the checks, including criminal record checks, can cost anywhere from £25 to £44. If there was a way to reduce these costs, then naturally it would become more accessible to more of the sectors and more of the markets, especially the sharing economy platforms in the volunteering sector, so that increasingly they would be able to provide a better service too. And finally is access to information and democratization of access to information. So already there are data sets that allow, for instance, banks to have access to illegal migrants, for instance. Now, if this was to be opened up to some of the other sectors, including the sharing economy, then naturally we would be better placed at helping them be able to essentially be fully compliant. So to summarize and to wrap up, it's a thrill to be here, and I'm really proud to be both a sponsor of and a supporter of Global Sharing Week. We are very much at the early stages of the growth of the sharing economy, and increasingly it's going to play, I believe, a growing part of the UK's future in the whole sector, and provide stability and employment for future generations. Thank you very much.